Good morning, everyone. A good Devach. Shavua Tov. We're continuing here in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, in the halachas of laws, of vows, and oaths. Mishenog is a chumra bedvar ma'amutar medina machma siyag v'gader. A person conducts themselves in a stringent manner in matters that are really permitted by halacha. However, he wants to make a protective fence around himself in order to make sure that he doesn't trample upon certain sins. Kagoyin tainyoy should be mea slichais, like we know certain people in the days of slichais, which is between or right before Rosh Hashanah, and then between Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, many people fast during those days. Or a person during the 3 weeks, which is coming up soon, doesn't eat meat or drink wine between Yud Zayin B'Tamuz, the 17th of Tamuz, and Tishmav, V'chayotzi Bo'ov, or similar cases where a person takes stringencies upon themselves in the world of mitzvah observance. Afilu Leinog Kein Rak Pam Rishayin, even if they only did it one time. Elishayim B'Daito Lino Kein Lo'elam, but when they did it one time, they had in mind they're going to do it forever like that. Or they did it 3 times, even though they didn't have in mind to do it for every single time, but they already did it 3 times. And they didn't make this condition that it should be bli neder without a vow. So they did an action 1 time or 3 times, and they didn't say bli neder. And now they decided they want to go back from what they were doing, meaning they don't want to keep this chumrah anymore because they're not healthy and they're unable to keep up with the stringency. Then, tzarech ha-Torah, they need what's called an annulment from the vow that they made. V'yiftach bechar, and we'll see in the next halacha how exactly you do a ha-Torah, how you'd make an annulment. So how do you start to annul? So you have to find a reason why you would regret that you did such a thing. You have to regret the fact that you conducted yourself in a manner that looks like you made a vow. A person who wants to keep certain stringencies in their life, for a protective fence, or they want to keep themselves separate from doing things that are wrong, he should say from the beginning, even though that I'm doing this noble practice over here, I'm doing it in a way that I'm not accepting a vow upon myself. And he should say, he should say, I'm only doing it this one time, or whatever times he wants to. However, but he's not doing these actions all of the time. It's just right now, the one or two or three things, the 3 times that he's planning on doing it. And that's how a person makes a vow and then tries to avoid the vow. Now, how do you annul vows and oaths? You have to go to 3 learned men. One of them at least has to be an expert in the laws of vows. He'll know which vow you're allowed to annul. And he knows which vows you're not allowed to annul. And after that, and how to annul them. And then these 3 people will be able to annul it for him. Someone who had a dream, and in his dream he took a vow. In that case, he should actually have 10 learned men who are going to gather around to nullify his vow. Okay, that's the way that annulment works. We'll see more of the details over here in the halachas of vows and oaths coming up, Be'ez Hashem, tomorrow. All the best.